like a game, yeah. Real man know how to play. I need to let you know. You're talking to them girls. Them running fast just to talk. Cause they don't know you the one. I need to let you know. Cause we get low and higher, baby.
Hello, Palpation Nation, and welcome to the vlog. Today is a beautiful winter's day. I'm heading out to a Hutter egg colony to cast a baby, no, not a baby calf, a feedlot calf's broken leg. For the rest of the day, I have booked just some drop-offs, and then also later this afternoon, I am giving a presentation to the Ontario Veterinary College via webinar. One of my veterinarians from the High Prairie Veterinary Clinic is over there right now, Dr. Kelly. She's originally from Ontario, and she went back and is giving a presentation on rural mixed practice. So I'll chime in and give a little bit of a history and background of Mosaic Veterinary Partners. That's my vet practice buying group. And yeah, then Kelly will stuff them full of pizza and we'll send them on their way. And maybe I'll find some more vet work to do. Remember, kids, sharp knife, sharp life. Come on. Hey, Jay.
Oh, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
Good, I just wanted to let you know.
Hello, Cody speaking.
Hey, Cody, it's
Diane. Hi, Diane, how are you?
Hi, good. You're probably pretty swamped too these days, aren't you?
Oh, yeah, it's been lots of meetings, and I'm driving out to cast a broken leg, and I got a postmortem to do, and...
If he wants to have a sleep, that's good. Let him sleep it off. He's using it already, boys. I think you guys are right.
I am the best cow vet.
Okay, I'll finish the call. I just finished a lunch and I feel a little sedate. They fed me, oh, what did we have? We had potato pancakes and duck and roast carrots and salad, and it was amazing. Oh, the colony food is the best. Yeah, so first off, what we did is we had to catch him. We were a little hesitant to run him through the chute system because we were worried maybe he would catch his leg or he would get stuck in the hydraulic squeeze. So we decided to pinch him, and he kind of got a little chasey and chased us out. Yeah, cue the chase scene. Oh my goodness, we watched that on replay over and over and over again after we finished the cast. So I gave him some xylazine and torbugesic to sedate him initially, and then went ahead and gave him some ketamine IV. I had to access the tail vein because I couldn't get the neck, and it just wasn't working good. I don't know, I just cannot hit the tail vein very well. I got a little bit of ketamine into him, enough to at least knock him down. We were able to get a rope on his head and tie up his legs, and then I got a jugular stick with the ketamine too. I would say he could have probably been a little bit more sedate, but we had a lot of help, so we were just able to mobilize him that way. We put 4 rolls of cast material on. It was a lower front right leg, and it was a transverse metacarpal fracture. So his front leg and just kind of in between where his knee is. And, well, in a cow, it would be this part, but you know what I mean. In between his knee and his fetlock. Got the cast material on, we got the rope off, we gave him an anti-inflammatory injectable, and then he just kind of chilled out for a little bit, and then he just popped up when he was putting weight on it, and he was perfect. Then I pre-tested one cow, a cull cow, she was open, and went in for lunch. I am on my way, stay on tripping when I come by, real gonna know how to play, I need to let you know. Ah, sheep. At the post-mortem pit now, I have one to do. I looked at this case, it was a neurological. It seemed like he was responding to thiamine treatment, so suspect polio encephalomalacia, but he went downhill over the weekend after improvement and now has perished. So I'm gonna do a post-mortem on him. I'll likely just take brain samples too and send that off for histopathology to see why he died. Need to know I'm a boss. We on the same damn team, yeah, yeah. We going down for the cause. I need to let you know, cause we get low and higher, baby. You know you can slide in, baby. Now just to take out the brain. Can you guys see its head? I'll finish the post-mortem as expected. I did not find any visible lesions, so I took the brain sample and I will send that off, and I promise to do a follow-up on this case. My camera is dead. I left it running and got a little carried away having a nice little conversation with the feedlot manager, but I'll be running off my phone for the rest of the day. Now I have one more delivery to do and I am heading back to the office for my webinar with the OBC. Got my microphone on a shoebox, super janky. Got a brand new webcam there. Got the Mosaic website up. Mosaic Veterinary Partners is a group of veterinarians that strives to elevate rural mixed practices through investment management and practice support. Mosaic, where dreams are made. Is that a Palpation Nation toque that I see in the very back? Yes! Okay, you're my new favorite friend. Running a vet practice is extremely complicated and there's a lot of moving parts. And sometimes, I know this is gonna be a shock to you guys, but sometimes veterinarians just wanna be veterinarians. They don't necessarily wanna spend till 2 a.m. working on drug pricing and then worrying about the two techs that are fighting and then just putting out fires every single day. Okay, I'm all finished my part of the talk. Now, Dr. Kelly is going to talk about high prairie practice. I edited this video. I'll include a clip of it inside of this video because I was just so proud. It's such a cute little practice. Oh, I just want to squeeze it.
I'll start there. So, high prairie veterinary services is where I work and live. It is.
Look how cute it is. I just love it so much. Okay, I'll finish for the day. The last thing is the people at Cattle Vac Box sent me a Cattle Vac Junior. So it's quite a bit smaller than the other Cattle Vac Box. I'll show you guys. So I'm actually gonna defect from carrying the big one when I go to processing calls and just carry the little one because it's got a helmet, 2 ports instead of 3 ports, and it's a little bit smaller. What are you doing?
What?
It has a helmet?
Did I say a helmet? A handle. It has a handle. It has a handle and two ports
like,
instead
really
of three
handy,
ports.
It, has a
it does not have a helmet. Why are you lurking in the shadows? The Creelman children. You guys like the kids, right? Should I include the kids or should I take them out? Maybe I should take them out of the vlog.
Where's your puppy?
I know.
Dad, watch how good I draw myself.
Let's see.
He did it all by himself.
Whoa! It looks just like you.
I look in here.
Stare at my gas hole.